Many times, the word meteorologist sparks questions from people that aren't quite sure what we do. A lot of the times, they think we study cosmic forces and asteroids and meteors. Unfortunately, no, we study more terrestrial atmospheres, such as the fluids above us here on Earth. But don't get us wrong, we love science, and today we'll see one of the most impressive displays of astronomy, and it's basically just geometry. This is what it looks like from outer space. Now, I'll remind you, none of this is actual relative size, but you get the idea. The moon passes in between the sun and the Earth. And the moon is actually pretty close, 240,000 miles away. The sun, on the other hand, is a whopping 93 million miles away. In order to observe this event, the most important thing you need are clear skies. And today, it looks like it's going to be optimal. The areas in blue are where clear skies are expected this afternoon.
High five!
The second most important thing you need to remember when trying to witness or to observe a phenomenon such as an eclipse is safety. The sun is very strong. It emits three different types of light. You've got ultraviolet light, infrared, and visible, but it's the UV light that does the most damage on your eyes. Now, a quick peek at the sun isn't going to melt the eyeballs out of your head, but you're better off using things like a welder's mask. Even better, how about an American flag welder's mask? That's a great idea. Designing a projector is a cheap and easy method. You can also get filters for your binoculars and telescopes, or you can get some cheap Mylar sunglasses from a museum or a hobby shop. Either way, conditions look ideal. Get out there and check it out.